Saduji, you are from Fiji Island. I have heard a lot about Sanatan Dharma in Fiji.
Yes.
Tell me a bit about your experience in your own Fiji Islands.
In Fiji, people were taken to Fiji back in 1860s as endangered laborers. They kept their Sanatan Dharma. They were taken from various parts of India, such as Bengal, Bihar, Maharashtra, and South India. So in Fiji, there's most of the population is from the northern part of India in Fiji.
Mm-hmm.
And mostly people in Fiji speak Bhojpuri language, which is mostly the main day-to-day language that they speak. And the all mixed Indians in Fiji from Bharat, they all speak mostly Bhojpuri, which is the market language, in-store language. And all of them, most of them, 60% of the population do follow Sanatan Dharma in Fiji. Before it was higher, but as the people have migrated from Fiji to New Zealand and Australia and to the America's West Coast and Canada West Coast, so the Sanatan Dharma has spread to those parts as the Fiji people have moved. And they are very much followers of Sanatan Dharma wherever they move to, whichever country. My family is in America since 1980s and they all follow Sanatan Dharma. Even my cousins, they're born here, but we all still follow the Sanatan Dharma.
Wow.
So you could see the Fiji people that have moved to any country, they have been still keeping their Sanatan Dharma because they feel that the sacrifice that their parents made when they were taken by British to Fiji and they were basically forcing to connect to other religion like Christianity and others and basically let go of our culture, our tradition, but our great-grandparents kept it alive. And they value to keep it alive. That's like their main belief, that we must keep it alive. If they work so hard to keep it, and we must keep it.
Fantastic. I just want to go and know a little bit more about Fiji. You have temples there. How do you go to worship? Do you remember anything like that that you would like to share? You have gone any time in the recent past? How is it?
I recently in 2014, May of 2014, I was in Fiji. And yes, Fiji has a lot of temples, a lot of historical temples, such as the one historical temple I've been to and I know a lot about is the Naga Temple in one of the islands in Fiji. And they believe that Naga Temple belongs to the Kaliya Naga, mm-hmm. the history behind when Krishna danced on the Kaliya Naga, and he said, why you are poisoning the Yamuna River? And Kaliya Naga said, because this is the only place that's safe where eagle cannot come and eat me.
Mm-hmm.
So then Krishna said, I will give you Ramanik Dweep. Ramanik Dweep is what's mentioned as Fiji in modern time today. And he said, I'm sending you to Ramanik Dweep where there's no eagle and you won't be harmed. So that temple, the Naga Temple in Fiji is called Naga Temple. If you look for Naga Temple Fiji,
wow.
you will find a lot of details. And that rock grows in the form of Naga and it grows every year.
Wow, that's amazing.
People from all over the globe go to that temple for their wish, for their prayer. There has been a couple who didn't have a child for more than 20 years of marriage and they had a child after visiting the temple. So that temple is very famous on Hindu believers across the globe.
So you find very good architectures like you see in India, the Fuji temples?
Fiji, one of the temple, no, not all temple have the architecture because they don't have the access to fund and bring all those big sculptures from Bharat, but one of the temple in Nandi, which is the international airport location in the main island, the Viti Levu, they have a South Indian temple built there by the people of South India and the artwork, that temple exactly looks like those temples in Bharat.
Wow.
Lot of hard work and a lot of money was put into that temple.
Fantastic. You want to say, how much percentage of the population in Fiji you think are Sanatana Dharmis?
It is about 60% population.
So the majority is Sanatana
Dharmis. Muslims and Sikhs.
Sikh also there.
Sikh community has grown recently due to the business in economy.
So there is so much difference between Sikh and Hindus anyway. So we don't
yes. do anything. And there, and the religions in Fiji all are very peaceful. They never fight over religion in that country.
Wow.
So that's they are the nicest Muslims, and all Christians and Hindu populations and Sikh populations. People live very flat. It's like the friendliest country in the world.
Wow. Okay. Great. Anything else you want to share about who is the main gurus there who are spreading the Sanatana Dharma there? You want to say anything about it?
Fiji doesn't have any special like sannyasi gurus because it has not come into the culture yet about the Bharat Sanskriti, because a lot of things were lost over time as when the British ruled Fiji, and the British ruled Fiji till October 10, 1970 is when Fiji got its independence.
Mm-hmm.
So till then they were under the control of British system.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And people mostly focused on survival and building up their life in Fiji as migrating from one country to another country. And they were living in an indentured labor system till 1970.
Wow.
So this is what we can view, that how after 1970 they had time to go back to their culture and their roots. And they started connecting to Bharat and bringing Bharatiya Sanskriti at more depth level, because they only practiced whatever they had in hand. Mostly people follow Ramayana and Lord Rama in Fiji.
So they do dramas, they do street dramas and those kind of thing?
Okay. Yeah, the main festivals they celebrate as Fiji, as entire population, people will celebrate Diwali, they will celebrate Holi,
wow,
Krishna Ashtami and Navami.
Wow.
And Navratri. Mm-hmm. So these are the main festivals they
really So it's like celebrate. More like Bharat itself.
It is a Bharat. Yeah, it's a very broad Bharat. It's not just like one state.
Wow, okay.
The whole Bharat is there, and they most of the population speaks Bhojpuri. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of, you even talk to a Fijian native or a Chinese person there, they will speak Bhojpuri Hindi too.
Wow, okay. That's very interesting piece
but
of
the white people that live there, the Brit, who Fiji is very diverse. They have mixed population, but the main street language is Bhojpuri. That's what it has become.
Wow. That is an official language of Fiji also, is it? Bhojpuri?
Anybody you meet there, you would know that they are speaking Bhojpuri.
Yeah, is Bhojpuri is a official language of Fiji also? Or?
Rather than English or Fijian language, Fijian is the native language of the country.
My question is Bhojpuri is one of the official languages of Fiji?
Yes, it's mostly the spoken language. People don't read and write in Bhojpuri. Yes, in school, Hindi is being taught. Most of the school names are Sanatan Dharma Elementary School. In most of the cities, but recently for past couple years the names are being transitioned back to a broader name where they are taking out Sanatana Dharma from the school names
they're removing the Sanatana Dharma name, you mean to say?
Yes, in some of the schools they have removed because they were questioning that the Christians and Muslims go. And but some places they have not questioned about it, but places where they have questioned to remove the name, some places have had the name removed.
That's no good news.
And yes, I would like to mention that in Fiji there is not Muslim conversions, but there's a lot of Christian conversions. A lot of Hindu families have converted, not a lot, but there are groups that are being converted to
they are into the vulture business anyway, so
yeah. So that was another reason, and because they live in, I mean, Fiji is not so much poverty but just the village life, but if you want to come out of village they kind of support you to serve mission as missionaries in Christianity, like in Australia and New Zealand, and then they give you money to go to school.
I will go in depth.
People are always there, as we know in Bharat, that's happening, recently started happening in North Punjab state.
Right.
The conversions, which it wasn't there. I mean, I went to Punjab in 2009 when I went to see my Guruji. And at that time, I didn't see many people in Punjab converting to Christianity. But recently, when I was there in 2017, And I seen on the, I was there for the month of the December in the time of Christmas. And on the day of Christmas, I saw a lot of people marching on streets with the spreading the Christianity. And I was amazed to see how many people were in that march. It was just, and then Guru Gobind Singh Ji, as you know, that in December month, Guru Gobind Singh Ji's four children gave Shahidi, they sacrificed for the country. Mm-hmm. And people of Punjab did not even recognize that. There was no march regarding that. There was no appreciation regarding that on the road. And when I saw this, I was really shocked. And I said, this is what you see at a mental slavery, I would say, you know, because you don't remember the land you live on, the grains you eat, these are there because of our gurus who have saved our land and die for us, sacrifice, and forget your thing and just practice what you are converted into. It doesn't make sense. I have given details about Fiji Dharma